Alright, I'm going to be showing you how to use the Twilight Renderer to modify the materials in your SketchUp file. So right now I've already built myself two scenes, and I already have something that works in sketchy physics, so you can see if I press play, I get my words to fall, and then I start having raindrops of balls falling down. What I want to do is start colorizing these materials. So if you look, your Twilight Renderer tools, this toolbar that looks something like this, what I'm mousing over right now, it's got a green circle, like a sun, paint bucket, some binoculars. I'm going to click on that paint bucket tool. And it's going to open up a new window. You can see I just dragged that window. And what we're looking to do is use the eyedropper tool and click on the material that I want to change. So right now, you can see I clicked on the word Academy. You can see that it's own shade of blue. In here, I can use some of the templates to change it to something else. So maybe I want to make these look like they are painted. Maybe I can make them glossed paint, and you can see the example of what it'll look like over here. You can see I got more of that glossy effect. You could even change how shiny your material is. And we can go ahead and do that for each one of these other ones. So I still have the eyedropper tool when I'm in the SketchUp window. I went to the word point, and I can go to my templates, which are the easiest ones to use. Maybe I'll use blue car reflection. We'll see how that changes it. Don't know if I like that so much. Maybe I will go to shiny plastic. It works for me. And I'll pick my word crown. You'll see it change. And maybe we'll have this one be metal. See how that turns out. I can close that window. Now what I can do is I can get a preview of it. So to preview how this is going to look, I can go into that green circle. It looks like an on button. Click that, and I get a brand new window. You can see this 800 by 600 is what it's going to default at. That's the size of the image it's going to give you. And here under render presets, you can render it all sorts of different ways. The higher up, the higher the number here, under this easier express setting, the higher the number, it's going to take longer to render. So if I use low plus, that'll be just fine. And I can just click play, and it's going to render the camera view that I currently have, and it's going to show me what that's going to look like using the materials I just selected. Now, I didn't select anything for my background, so there's going to be real plain. And you can see down here, you can watch how long it's going to take. This one will usually take around 30 seconds or so. And you can see it took 43 seconds to render. Now that gives me an idea of what all my words are going to look like. Now maybe I want to change that crown. Maybe I don't like how that looks. Maybe I want to make them uniform. So at this point, I could save this image. I could do save as, render, save as. I could save that picture. But I'm not worried about that right now. So I'm going to go back in here, and I'm going to open up that materials editor again. And I'm going to set all of mine to car paint. Oh no, not car paint. Let's see, what did I pick before? Oh, just normal paint. Normal paint, high gloss, and I changed my gloss to 200. And now I have that done. And also now, go up. Oops. can see where all the balls are that I have that are going to rain down on stuff. And you can see I have a few different colors. So any color you pick, so once I do one of these yellow ones, it's going to be the same. It's going to do the exact same thing for all the other yellow ones. So each color is individual. So maybe I want to pick these as glass. Maybe I'm picking them all as glass, and it says air glass. I'm not even sure exactly what that is, but we'll find out here soon. So go ahead and play around, change the materials on all your objects, and do a practice render and see what happens.